Good morning students, 11th standard biozoology. So the topic is nutritional and digestive disorder. Nutritional and digestive disorder. What is the nutrition? So they have a balanced diet. Already know about the balanced diet. The food is consist of carbohydrate, protein, fat, vitamins, mineral salt and water, they occur in a correct proportion. It is called a balanced diet. Any deficiency occurs in the nutrition, so they produce different kinds of disease. Different kinds of disease. And also, so the digestive tract or the digestive system, the tract is a consist of a numerous bacteria and viral, and they have a protozoa, so are present. So due to this infection, so the inflammations occur in the colon. So the colon means mostly they occur in the larger intestine. So the inflammations occur in the colon. So this condition is called in a clotist. So the inflammations occur in the colon is called the clostitis. C-O-L-I-T-I-S. Clotis. The most common symptoms of the clotis is abdominal pain, a rectal bleeding, and they have in a diarrhea. So the abdominal pain, a rectal bleeding, and they are mostly they occur in a diarrhea. So the first nutritional deficiency disease is, so they have in a protein molecule. So they have in a, so the protein deficiency. So the protein energy malnutrition PEM. So the protein energy malnutrition, it means the deficiency of the protein. So the proteins are used for the development of the muscle system. So the development of all the body organ, not only the body organ, but also they control the biological reaction occur in the human body. So the protein diet, so during the early age is very very essential. So the deficiency of the protein in early ages, so they produce two kinds of disease. One is called marasmus. So the two important, so disease called in a marasmus and Kawasaki. They have in a, so the Kawasaki. So the two important disease, they occur due to the deficiency of the protein molecule during the early age. So the disease are mostly they occur in a before the poverty line. So what is the symptoms of Kawasaki? What is the symptoms of Kawasaki? A dry skin, a bulging belly. So the abdomen is become very enlarged in size. So edema in the leg and the face. So the abnormal growth of the muscles in the face as well as the leg. And the sudden growth, the growth is arrested. So it is called a sudden growth. That changes the hair color. And also they become the weakness occur in the body. So then, what is the symptoms of the marasmus? So the marasmus So the main symptom is the bone is covered by skin. So the more than 1 month, so the prolonged diarrhea has occurred in the young one. So finally, the bone is covered with the skin. So this condition due to the diet of inadequate carbohydrate and protein. These are the two kinds of disease they occur in the children. So the deficiency of the carbohydrate as well as the, so they have a protein molecule. So children suffer in the diarrhea. Bodies become to very lean and they become to weak. So what is the quantity of the proteins are needed in the human life? So the 1 kg of body weight, they need 1 gram of protein per day. So the 1 kg of the body weight, they need 1 gram of your protein per day by recommended by World Health Organization. World Health, so the organization. So the next disease is called indigestion. So what is the meaning of indigestion? So the indigestion means is the digestive disorder, which is a food is not properly digested. Food is not properly digested because the enzyme secretions are very less and the physical activities are very less. So they're feeling fullness of the stomach. They're having a fullness of the stomach. So the overeating, the process is called, so the overeating. It may be due to the inadequate enzyme secretion. A less amount of enzymes are secreted. And also they have an anxiety. It's a fear also they use for the indigestion. And also they have a food poisoning. So they have a, so food poisoning is also they produce an indigested problem. And overeating. And the spicy food. So they consume the large quantity of the spicy food. So they are having an indigestion that takes place. So next process is called the constipation. What is the meaning of constipation? In this condition, the feces are retained. The undigested food materials are retained in the rectum more than 2 days or 3 days. So the ejections cannot be takes place. So they occur in the rectum region because the inadequate of the fiber food and they have a less amount of water intake. So the lack of fiber and also the lack of water quantity because of the, and also they form an irregular bowel movement, they occur in the body. So they have a constipation that takes place due to the poor intake of fiber and the diet of lack of physical exercise. Mainly they are the a less amount of water are intake. They causes the constipation. So next one is called the vomiting. The reverse peristalsis movement. So the peristalsis movements are used for the food particle from the mouth to stomach. But they have an irreversible, a peristaltic movement, the food particle move from the stomach to the mouth part. So this condition is called in a vomiting. This process is called in a, so the vomiting. So the, because of the contaminated food, and also they have a contaminated water. So the heavy food say intake without any physical activities they take and rest during this time, so the vomitings that takes place. This action is controlled by the vomiting center. Vomiting center is present in the medulla oblongata. In the medulla oblongata, they have been a vomiting center. The vomit is controlled by the vomiting center. The feeling of nausea, they proceed the vomiting. So the feeling of nausea, they proceed the vomiting. These are some kinds of nutritional deficiency disease, and also they are having a digestive disorder. One is called the PEM, a protein energy malnutrition. So the second one is called indigestion. Third one is called the constipation. Fourth one is called the vomiting. So the next disorder, see the next video. So thank you very much, students.